In the quiet forest, the upright fir trees set off the majesty and mystery of the forest. At that moment a man appeared in the forest, only to see him slowly stepping on the wet lawn without a sound. What the man was looking for? We did not know. At this point, he did not realize that a male lion was slowly approaching him. Just when we thought the lion was going to attack the man, the next scene took everyone by surprise. The lion suddenly pounced into the man's arms. At this time the man was stroking the lion's head in a doting manner. And the ending was completely different from what we expected. What is the story of this man and the lion? The lion is a feline. We know that when felines are attached to their human parents, long periods of time together will allow them to build a deep bond. And even if they end up separated for a long time, they still remember the family that once adopted them. At this time, even a fierce male lion, at this moment for humans, is a gentle kitten. Today we are going to talk about the warm story between a lion, Kyra, and its owner, Adolphus. On this day, the hunter Adolphus was hunting in the forest as usual. It was already late winter, full of fallen leaves appeared to be no little life in the forest. At that moment, not far away from the bushes came the sound of moth rustling. Hunter's intuition forced him to slowly approach the bush. Picking up the bush, he saw a newborn lion cub caught in a trap and injured in the legs. It looked like the lion cub must have gotten separated from its family because of playfulness. In the bitter cold winter, the bitter cold wind blowing from time to time could not help but give Adolphus a chill. Such weather, without family members to help hunt for food, the lion cub must be difficult to survive. Adolphus looked around and saw no sign of other lions. He made a decision. He would take the lion cub home to raise. Adolphus slowly opened the trap and gently picked up the lion cub. Because the weather was too cold, Adolphus did not hesitate to take off his jacket, wrapped tightly around the lion cub. At first, for the sudden appearance of Adolphus, the lion cub felt afraid, but also a little curious. It was possible to feel Adolphus's kindness. It slowly put down the guard. The furry little head was rubbing in Adolphus's arms, with its bright little eyes slippery turn around. Adolphus's heart was melting at this time. He stroked the lion cub's head and said gently, "From now on you will live with me." The lion cub felt Adolphus's warmth, as if it took him for its mother, blinked its little eyes and licked Adolphus's face. Adolphus showed a warm smile, when the winter did not seem so cold. Adolphus then took the lion cub back to his home. When they back home, Adolphus first helped the lion cub clean up the wounds, and named the lion cub Kyra. The lion cub seemed to like the name and kept rubbing its head against Adolphus's hands, a harmonious and warm picture. The next period of time, the lion cub Kyra lived together with Adolphus. Because Kyra was still young, it was more mischievous, either scratching Kyra's sofa curtains, or jumping up and down to drop things everywhere. But Adolphus was not angry at all, but dotingly stroked Kyra's head and tenderly called the lion cub's name. Under the careful care of Adolphus, Kyra's injuries were getting better day by day, and its body had grown a lot, and its limbs had become strong, unlike the skinny look when they first met. During the day, the lion cub Kyra would accompany Adolphus hunting. And at night it would stay with Adolphus in the fireplace next to the fire. Although the days were dull, it also full of warmth. In this way Kyra accompanied Adolphus through the seasons. In the blink of the eyes, Kyra had grown from a lion cub to a majestic adult lion. It was no longer as ignorant and playful as when it was a child, but now revealed the majesty of the king of the forest everywhere. When you looked at it, you would be afraid. But Kyra was very docile in front of Adolphus, because they had long regarded each other as the closest family. The neighbors all knew that Adolphus adopted the lion, although they were fear, they were peaceful. But Kyra was now an adult lion, the neighbors were quite afraid that it would accidentally hurt their family. So the neighbors reported Adolphus's adoption of Kyra to the local wildlife agency. On that day, the Wildlife Conservation Service officers visited Adolphus at his home. As soon as they entered the door, they saw Kyra, which was sensing danger, immediately yelled at the officer in charge, who was stunned on the ground. Adolphus sensed that Kyra did not like these people and immediately hugged the alert Kyra, gently stroking Kyra's head and telling Kyra not to be afraid. Kyra also gradually calmed down under Adolphus's reassurance. Adolphus took the leader of the Wildlife Conservation Service to the room without Kyra. Once inside the door, the person in charge made his intentions clear, saying that Kyra was a wild lion, although living with Adolphus for many years, it did not meet the local regulations. In addition, Kyra was now an adult lion. If it accidentally harmed the local residents, it would be dangerous, then it would be too late to take enforcement measures, so he hoped Adolphus would send Kyra back to the forest. Adolphus seemed to have anticipated their intention. He was not surprised by the attitude of the person in charge. But there was no choice, for the sake of Kyra's future growth and the safety of the local residents, he agreed to send Kyra back to the forest, although he was sad to do so. After sending off the head of the Wildlife Conservation Service, Adolphus walked up to Kyra's side, his eyes full of despondency. He did not know what to say, directly hugged Kyra and cried out in pain. Kyra seemed to understand everything, and kept licking Adolphus's face, as if to comfort him. The next day Adolphus took Kyra back to the forest where it was picked up, but this time, Adolphus left Kyra in the forest forever. Since then Adolphus had never gone hunting in the forest again. Without Kyra, Adolphus spent 6 years in this way. 6 years later, Adolphus revisited the same place. On this day, Adolphus came to the forest where he had seen Kyra. He did not know whether he could see Kyra again, he just missed Kyra. Adolphus was walking aimlessly in the forest, suddenly a huge figure rushed out from the bushes, which was a lion. Adolphus sat down in fear, but the next moment the lion pounced on his arms. He took a closer look and it was his Kyra. Adolphus cried tears of joy, and Kyra rubbed its head against him, whimpering. Kyra remembered when it was a child, when they always played like this. Adolphus stroked his big cat approvingly, stroked Kyra's back tenderly, and finally they both lay happily on the ground, playing together like old friends. The relationship between humans and animals has been known to us since ancient times. Animals are close friends of humans. And humans are dependent partners of animals. Humans originally evolved from animals into intelligent and advanced creatures, and always have an inextricable relationship with animals. We tame animals and give them love and respect. Animals are sometimes afraid of humans. And after feeling the kindness of humans, they will show their docile side to humans and live in harmony with them.